there. Welcome to the first lesson in this choreography. To begin this lesson, we're going to start, let's see, where did I want you to start on this one? We were going to start on the back side of the pole. And we're going to have our hands palm to palm on the pole. And I'm not pushing down or anything like that. I'm just sort of resting here, but I'm not pushing on the pole at all. From here, you're going to move your hips side to side 4 times, and you're going to use up 2 counts each. So it'll be 1, 2, and it's best if you do this flat-footed. For beginners, it works easier. But if you come up onto your toes, toes are angled at the corners of the room, heels slightly inward. If you come up onto your toes, then it looks much better. You're slightly hinged forward in the waist, palms on the pole, and then you have 1, 2, pushing my weight into my right hip, 3, 4, left hip, 5, 6, right hip, and then pushing it back for 7, 8, and on the count of 8, you're going to pop your head up, leaving the weight in the left hip. From here, you're going to use 4 counts to come all the way back over to your right leg. Left arm comes with a pull, so it'll be 1, 2, 3, and 4, sucking this left leg up so that we can start to walk on it. And then our walks will be 3 walks forward, which would be 1, 2, and 3, across the pole for 4. This is my right leg, the leg that faces the audience. Okay? So just to do that much with the count, it's gonna look like this. Gaze down at the floor. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, pop the head on 8. Up for 1, 2, 3, 4, and then we have 5, 6, 7, leg 8. Now you want this leg to go across the pole so that my foot is on the other side of the pole, because we're going to change sides of the pole. From here, you're going to push your bottom back and away and lean towards the audience. Don't drop the chest when you do this. Leave the chest up, but it's just the butt that pushes back in a way, and you switch positions, so now my hips face the opposite wall. From here, the front leg goes backwards behind my leg. The front leg goes to the side. And then when I'm getting behind the pole, my left leg goes forward. So it'll be this backside front movement. So just to review that again, we have our walking forward here. Then we have our hips for 1, 2, 3, and 4. Hips face opposite wall. And then we have back, side, front. Notice that I'm on the opposite side of the pole again, left leg forward. I'm going to quickly bring the chest to the pole and pop the head up. Just to do that much with the counts, from the beginning it looks like this. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, leg 8, 1, 2, 3, hips 4, 5, 6, 7, pop 8. Okay? Always keep the hand right here on the hip if you don't know where to put it, and don't be afraid to caress your body as you do these movements. They're kind of slow and sultry little dance. Okay? From here, after you pop the head on 8, you're going to do a back body roll or reverse body roll, which means instead of going to the pole, we're going to go away from the pole. Begins with the head, chest, hips, and sit and stand it up. And it's one slow long one taking up 4 counts. So we would have a head on 8 and then 1, 2, 3, and 4. From here, switch your grip to the right arm, step across the back side of the pole with your left leg in a very strong lunge, draw the hand up the inside of the thigh, push the weight up into that left leg as you drag the hand up the inside of the leg in that line till it hits your hip. Do the exact same thing on the right leg. Switch your grip, lunge across, hand on inner thigh. As you come up, pull the hand up the inner thigh and across the hip area. For here, you'll lunge back the opposite direction, but leave your weight square in the middle. So it comes forward this way, and you're going to come down into a lunge. Now remember that when you come down into a lunge, it's really important that your knees stay open to the back wall. If they're not open to the back wall, your legs look like this. It's not the same. The knees should be exactly stacked over the ankle bone, And your spine should be as if you're sliding down a wall. The hips are slightly tucked under. The bottom is not sticking out. So be sure that you're going straight down when you go into this lunge and you're up on your toes. For beginners, you can leave your feet flat and come down into a lunge with your heels on the floor if it's too intense to have your toes up. So just to do that much with the counts, where we left off here, where we would have our rocks forward here on eight, we have one, two, three, four, we have five, six, seven, hip, eight. One, two, three, and four. Lunge across four. Five, six, seven, up, eight. One, two, three, four. Press the middle for five, six, and then as you get to the bottom for seven, you're gonna have seven, eight, one, two, up, three, and four. So you're only in that lunge for a little bit before you start to just move your hips to the right, left, right, left, and then stand up out of it so that your weight is on the left or the right side. So just to review that again, we have our lunge here, and we have our lunge here. Immediately going down into your lunge for one, two counts, okay? Which it'll end up being five and six here. And then you'll have seven, eight, one, two. Push it all the way up to three, four. I have to really push my weight into this right leg and stand up on it. And my left leg is pointed. From here, you're gonna do a fan kick. It doesn't matter which hand is on the pole at this time when you come up, whatever's comfortable for you. But you wanna come back to having both hands on the pole, especially if you're a beginner. To do the fan kick, you're gonna transfer your weight into the front leg. The right leg is gonna kick through as you come to a strong hold grip. And then the legs kick up and around. And you change sides of the pole, okay? If you don't know how to do a fan kick, then please see the individual tutorial on how to do that, okay? Immediately following the fan kick in this choreography, we're gonna turn it into a pike pole sit. So, if we're here, and we go for our fan kick, we're going to go to our strong hold, kick the right leg up for fan kick. When the right leg grounds itself on the other side, we keep the left one in the air, so it looks like this. Left leg stays in the air and comes all the way around for a pike pole sit. Slightly lean your hips off to one side or the other. Preferably in this choreography to the left side if you need to intensify your grip and get a better grip on the inside of your thighs, okay? So just to do that much with the counts, for that little ending piece, we have coming down to our wide-legged lunge. Okay, and we're here on 5, 6. We have 7, 8, 1, 2, up, 3, 4. Change the weight and grip for 5, 6, and then kick through 4, 7, and 8, and then pulse it for 1, 2, 3, 4. In the count of five, you're gonna lean off to the left and fold the legs back. Right arm comes around and you're going to swan. And then you're gonna set that left foot down, regrip up top, and the momentum will take you around and you'll face front. If you don't know how to do the swan, there is a tutorial for that as well, and you can go back and review how to do that. So that last sequence is a little bit intense for beginners, and you may have to work for this piece, because you're gonna go right through your fan kick, then into your pike sit, and then into the swan. If you're not ready for the swan, and a lot of beginners aren't, they kind of have to work into that, then you will just wanna sit with the legs folded back, and don't do the arms part of the swan, but rather just sit on the pole and fold the legs back. It would look like this. We're here, so we have fan kick, pike, and instead of doing the upper body and swan, lean left, so it's correct, fold the legs back, and just hold here, both hands on the pole. Same thing, come down with the left leg, this comes all the way up, and you're going to face front, okay? So, that ends the choreography for this lesson, to do it all the way from the beginning with the counts. This is what it's going to look like. Okay, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, head, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, up, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight.